Hi, and welcome to another moment with Mike and Lois.
Hi.
So we're talking about vision this week.
Yeah.
And it's amazing how two people looking at exactly the same thing can actually see completely differently by what their mind is doing in terms of interpreting what they're seeing.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, there's that little saying that I included in my book years and years ago. Two men looked out from prison bars, one saw mud, one saw stars.
Mm.
One saw the negative, and one saw the positive.
And
isn't it how we are in our lives sometimes, which is why we need each other, because we can see one thing, and depending on really our circumstances and the way we're viewing things right now, which can be clouded by things, we could end up being negative, whereas someone without that information could actually come in and all they can see are positives in our lives. And so I went on to say opportunity has to be seen before it's realized, and how our vision always needs to be God's vision, based around God's word, fulfilled through God's church, and achieved for God's purpose. And when we know who God is, that enables us to know who we really are. So we looked at four things that vision does. Firstly, a vision gives us a sense of direction. And when we have a vision in our life, we have direction for our life.
We live in a town that is known as a retirement town. And it is or was a place where a lot of people would used to holiday and then would they come back here for retirement because they remember the good old days. But we kind of have this saying in it's different now because things are changing dramatically in our town. But we used to say, didn't we, that the teenagers would retire at 16. Because they would go through their school days and then they'd leave school at 16 and then have no hope for themselves, have no vision of what they wanted to do, because it seemed to be a town that would just kind of swallow them up and not give them any opportunities. Now that is changing, but it was such a shame to see how people, because when they don't have a vision, they just give up. They have no sense of direction, and so they just think, well, that's it in life.
No direction.
No direction.
Because
you've got to have the direction.
Secondly, we said a vision gives us a sense of purpose.
This is it, isn't it? You see, if you don't know where you're going, how do you know when you've got there? You've got to have a goal in life. And that's the vision, isn't it? It's the goal that's something that you work towards. And it's once you've got that vision in front of you, the journey is all about getting to that goal. And so you've got to have that sense of
direction, you know,
where you're going.
Vision gives us a sense of purpose and enables us to pursue the calling on our lives. There's a calling on our lives.
Every single one of us.
You know, vision gives us that purpose.
Yeah.
And everybody needs to have a sense of purpose, because that sense of purpose gives us a sense of being useful useless.
You get up every morning. Otherwise, why is it up every morning? Because you get up to fulfill your purpose, don't you? You don't just get up just to... You get up, go to work, come back, go to bed, get up, go to work.
It's a greater purpose.
There's a far greater purpose to what you are doing.
Thirdly, a vision gives us a sense of responsibility. In other words, when we have a vision for tomorrow, it encourages us to live responsibly today. In a world that really doesn't care about tomorrow, you know, it gets on today with no care in the world about tomorrow. But when you have a vision, you take care about the way you live today, because you want to make it till tomorrow.
Every decision you make is getting you either closer to or further away from your vision. You can't live a reckless life if you have purpose in your life, because everything that you do and say, every decision you make should be getting you closer to that purpose.
Lastly, a vision gives us a sense of achievement. Everybody needs to feel fulfilled and whole.
That's right.
And if you've got no sense of fulfillment, then the chances are you haven't got a sense of your purpose, and that's because you haven't got a vision. But when you've got a vision, you will feel fulfilled in what you do.
Yeah, absolutely.
There we go. Well, we're going to get on to the first point tomorrow.
Okay.
I'm not sure how we're going to do it in 2 days, but you know, we want to point you to the full message, because there's a lot more that I shared on Sunday that we obviously can't share on here. So we'll get onto that tomorrow. Mm-hmm. But whatever you're doing today, I hope that that's helped, and we'll see you again tomorrow. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.